Prepare yourself for a sprawling discussion on just about anything, where critical thinking meets pop culture in a collision of mind-bending proportions. Please secure all neurons and prepare for full frontal cortex. It's time for Incoherent Ramblings.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the next episode of Incoherent Ramblings. I'm your host, Joey Shamelow. We also got
Paul Hunter,
Kale Anderson,
and Daryl Jors.
Today's topic is, as I said, Superstition! Part 3, the conclusion of my Super series, because it was my choice. You farted.
Oh, super fart.
You'll get some. I already got something! Okay.
Isn't it really a lot louder without the headphones on?
It is, yes.
You're right, it is! That's oh my right. God!
Are your headphones back?
No.
In fact, why are we using the distributor? I'm the only one.
I wanted my headphones on. I wanted my headphones on.
I do.
I get distracted.
Alright.
With your headphones on.
Well, that's too far, but... Wait, I only got 2 minutes of this, damn it! Alright.
Oh.
Today's topic is superstition, and today's sponsor is Stevie Wonder! Superstition. So the subtopics today are gonna be number 1, intro to superstition, number 2, traditional superstition. Number 3 will be good luck and bad luck. Next will be urban legends, then viral myths, conspiracy theories, sports superstitions, superstitious beliefs, the superstitious frame of mind, and a superstitious conclusion.
Slow down some.
Remember, you can always reach us at show@iamrambling.com. And remember, please leave some sort of...
Man, that didn't smell like science.
Please leave us some comments.
Smells like Daryl.
All right, is it time for the beer ramble?
Smell like we want
you to please email us topics.
Oh, I am, okay.
Because
am I close? No. Yeah, you've got like...
We want to do what you want us to do. And we'll do it on camera now.
Yeah. That's right. Time the camera. Intro. Maybe what? It should just be on after all. We could start the timer next time after.
Yeah, maybe that's a good way to go.
Well, this seems like
we go pre-ramble, pre-ramble.
Right, right. Okay. 4. 3.
Pre-ramble, pre-ramble, pre-ramble.
Quiet, man. What happened?
Okay, so I have once again decided to change my pre-ramble topic because it's been so serious with these science-y guys over here, so I'm going to make mine more fun. But I'm not going to call it...
So serious.
I'm not going to call it the fun zone. I'm going to call it... You know, it's going to have all the WTF moments in life.
Wait, wasn't fun zone a Weird Al song?
Yeah, that's
why I thought it was.
So this is my new topic. It's going to be...
What the fruit?
So today on
What the fruit?
Wait, do I have to bleep that?
No, you don't. Actually, no, you don't.
Only in Switzerland or in Sweden.
In Sweden. There you go.
Nike.
What the fruit? They said What the fruit.
Nike was selling a shoe, the Nike Air Foam Composite, and it was one of those shoes, and it's got like stars and galaxies on it, and they were selling it for $3,000. So the review. So What the fruit? So the best, of course, are the reviews. So I'm going to read 2 really quick. 5 out of 5. Sure, these shoes are pricey, but you get what you pay for. I work 60 hours a week all year long, and I was finally able to purchase these shoes. I put them on, I could immediately tell they weren't your average $60 sneakers. Sure, they had the same amount of foam, comfort, shape, and performance, but they were way more stylish. Like $3,000 stylish. Sometimes my daughter complains. She'll say things like, are we going to eat tonight? And I'm tired of sleeping in the street. I just show her my awesome Nikes, and she shuts her bitch mouth. Oh, great man. Shoes. Do recommend. And then the next one was wearing these shoes in combination with the 3 Wolf 1 Moon shirt. I notice people feel compelled to fall to their knees in my presence. I can't say I dislike it.
The wolf shirt, yes.
So, what the frick? I mean, really, $3,000. But I guess some people bought them.
Oh, my God.
They've got,
are they collectible or something?
They look like the wolf, like the shirt with the stars. You know, Daryl, you've got one of those. But it's not like on the shoes. So, we'll put
a
link.
Is it diamond encrusted or something?
All right. Yeah. That was for.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He can't hear the bell.
I heard it.
Okay.
Because it's so loud. Word of the week! Yes, it is your weekly word of absolutely nonsense.
He forgot what it was.
Today's...
It wasn't that first one you mentioned, I hope.
No.
Okay, good.
Today's word is a Cincinnati Ferris wheel.
Oh, yeah, the Cincinnati bow tie was really bad, so...
Yeah.
That's right, we did that one.
Well, does it mean... The Cincinnati bow tie had to do with poop, so is this, like... Yeah. Is Cincinnati, like, mean poop? I don't know. Cincinnati Ferris, well, if it was, would be you poop and then you spin around.
Well, I think it, what it's got to be is it's a group of guys, because it's always guys, right?
Oh, no.
It's a group of guys. One guy is in the middle, and the other guys, there's six of them, and they all penetrate him as they go around the circle.
Duck, duck, f***.
Oh, right then.
It's not as bad, is it?
Dick, dick.
Making my work easier by the minute.
Yes.
Well, what I think it is since they refer to the Ferris wheel, they're not talking about the entire wheel, but the general structure of how it's set up. As one person one person taking a dump the regular way, and another person behind them doing the double decker style. Second deck.
Could you explain the double deck?
No, I don't want him to explain it to me.
All right, Paul, is it? Right,
actually, Joey was the closest, and I'm very proud that you guys
remembered
some Cincinnati in it. It's the act of taking a dump while doing a cartwheel naked, not fully knowing where your dump will land.
Oh, my God.
What happened to poor Cincinnati that they're like...
I don't know.
They're like...
Word of the week!
They're like... Whoa! All dude! Right. Face! Butt! Not good!
And that's filmed now.
Yes.
Mike's here, so yeah. Okay, thank you, Paul, for working.
Mike, you're in there? Mike?
Hey, now you have to do that. You have to smell.
Now I have to smell.
Wait, especially now.
Here's it.
Oh my God!
You just had to get pet face before the podcast.
I know.
That doesn't Don't smell like science.
We just had Rieto burritos with lots of beans.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Yes. Smells like science. Go.
Oh my God. It does not smell like science.
That's bad is because when I was down there, I didn't smell it. When I sat back up, I smelled it.
Oh my God.
No, but mine's not. Don't worry.
It smells like gag reflex.
Cut too much into this. Okay. There's a group of scientists that are now
found doing the Cincinnati Ferris wheel. Go on.
Have given a type of bacteria that eats the sludge and then produces their poop is gold. Pure 99.9% pure gold.
So it's a Cincinnati gold poop or something?
That's it.
Wow. So, okay, with bacteria that poops. Wait.
Yeah.
Wait, does it smell like gold or science?
It's gold. 99.9%.
So wait, can they just create it then?
That's what I'm saying.
What do they have to ingest?
At first you think, oh my God, they're going to be able to make gold. But the thing is that the sludge has to be this form of gold sludge that normally you can't get gold out of, but these bacteria eat the sludge and then poop out the gold.
Okay, so they separate it from the other minerals.
Exactly.
Okay.
So
it's all part of the gold protein.
They are producing gold, pure gold.
I was about to joke and say you have to feed them gold, but that turns out that's
so actually, this could be like the cash for gold places will start getting this bacteria to get more gold out of their...
Literally get shit for gold.
Call 1-800-SHIT for gold!
What did you say in the comment? You were like... Something about alchemy?
Yeah, alchemy. Alchemy, Bagura.
Oh, that was it.
Yeah. Okay, and now it's time for deck talk. Yeah. That's enough. Okay, so.
I was expecting much more.
That's enough,
That's probably enough of saying, deck talk. So, there's a new device that they cleared their Kickstarter campaign. They made it into the clear. They were trying to get $40,000 pledged. They wound up with $695,000.
Why couldn't that happen to my time?
Like, really, they came up with a really good idea, though. It's called Pressy. And what it is a cell phone add-on. It goes into the headphone jack of the cell phone, but it sits flush, and it's just a push button. So it's a physical button you can add to your phone. And they combine that with software that basically lets you program how you can use it. So, for example, you can make it a quick thing where... You simply press that button once and you snap a photo.
Oh,
okay? I see.
And then you can do different things like you can program anywhere from 1 to 3 taps, and they can be all short or long taps, so you can go to a lot of different combinations.
It's like Morse code.
A quick double tap could be like phone home, right? And stuff like that. So it just adds this physical button that will go into your headphone jack. It's very compact and it looks pretty cool.
That actually does sound cool.
And they're aiming for something like a under $20 street price. Their Kickstarter you could pledge $15 or more to get one of them, plus the software. But I think they're aiming to go like $17 came with
$19.99.
I think the $15 one is limited supply, and $17 assured that you would get one item. So they met their goal, and they're going to be making it. So it sounds pretty cool. And as a little aside, one thing that we found out about and we posted onto our Facebook page is that you can now cast Google Drive presentations to the Chromecast, and we started using that to put our notes that we use during our recording onto Kale's Big Train.
All right, guys, today is Superstition, so I want to start off with an intro to Superstition. I want to talk about what we mean by it, and because it's not just going to be traditional superstition.
I'm not superstitious about farts, though, because that's real harm.
That's real harm.
You can't see them.
We're not just talking about bad luck and black cats, and although we will discuss that. We're also talking about just the state of mind of how superstition comes to be and the superstitions in these days, such as urban legends and with the internet, viral myths, and, of course, conspiracy theories. And what I really want to look at is sports superstitions, because people get really serious about that. So what do you guys think about superstitions? How do you see them or experience with any of them?
Do I have to come last?
No, go ahead. Go.
Okay.
I'll let you come first.
I think superstitions are a product of people being really good pattern recognizers. Mm-hmm. And a lot of them are born from simply associating things. Because especially the sports ones happen that way. It's like you're wearing a particular pair of socks to the event, right? And you notice, the two games we won this year, out of all the other games, I was wearing this particular pair of socks. Mm-hmm. Then you start to associate that as being your lucky totem. Like, this is the thing that's going to make me win games from now on.
It starts becoming a self-fulfilling prophecy.
That too, because, it's a confirmation bias of first of all identifying it. Then once you're convinced, you want to make it true. So you're right. You might go on the field and play harder because you're wearing your lucky socks. Yeah. Right.
It becomes a placebo effect.
It's like the
effect.
Trolls that that people use at bingo tournaments and stuff and all that.
Yeah.
Lucky trolls.
Yeah.
So,
and then
so again, it's just, that's how it's started.
I know for myself that I don't believe in superstition, but there will be things that I'm doing, and I realize I'm using that frame of mind, where I'm thinking, if I do it this way, it's going to work better or something.
Well, even though, like, last week we kind of shot down a lot of supernatural stuff, it's not like some of those things can't be tools. Like, you can try to read someone else's mind, and maybe you have some intuition there that's
you'll
going
still
to help
be a tool.
You get there. But I'm not saying that depends upon some ethereal
connection. I know it seems like last week, but it was really like 4 months, 4 weeks ago.
True.
Yeah.
All right. You're right.
What do you think about superstition, Paul?
I agree with Daryl.
Okay, cool. Cal?
No,
go ahead, Paul.
I took all the time on that one.
I like how what he's talking about pattern recognition. It's also a way to maybe calm yourself down. It's repetition.
What do you mean calm yourself down?
Like in I don't know if we want to get to it,
like
in sports.
Sees Kale, he's all
and stuff.
Like,
there's certain things that
that's like a cold
athletes may do to kind of calm themselves and get them in the frame of mind of what the performance they're about to do.
Probably
porn stars too.
You sometimes get like a little stage fright doing performances or
It's like that sport. It's that the plot device where it's always this is your the Dumbo thing. This is your lucky feather, and you can do this with it, and really it's nothing. And just the last second it goes away, but it's just
and you.
You
do it
anyway.
Yeah.
Depend on yourself. It was all in your mind anyway.
Kale, real quick.
I don't believe superstitions are real, but. As I said, I think they become self-fulfilling prophecies.
But the phenomena is real because people believe in them, right?
The phenomenon that people believe in superstition is real.
They don't actually do anything.
Superstitions themselves are not correct.
But again, it's like doing anything in life is about rearranging the pattern of your neuronal connections and all that. So I think sometimes superstitions, they might be a misguided way to get there, but you can actually train yourself to do better through something superstitious. I think that's possible.
And that's training yourself to do better through superstition, but superstition itself is not real.
Right.
And that's what I said.
Right. Where what superstition is, what you're saying is there is some... Yes.
All right.
traditional superstition.
What the fuck?
Yeah. Black cats walking under ladders, four-leaf clovers, ladders again. Why did I put that twice? Opening umbrellas in the house, breaking mirrors, stepping on cracks.
Actually, I guess I copied and pasted that, so it was you.
Huh. Yeah, it was me. Sorry.
Sorry.
So.
Snorting on crack.
What?
You don't want to step on your crack.
Wait, you break mirrors while you're snoring.
That's a lot of money.
That would be bad luck.
As I was looking up, interesting. As I was looking up Superstition, you get the two sides to it, like with the comic strips and everything. You get the one side of showing that Superstition doesn't exist. And then you get the one that's showing the person saying, well, there's no such thing as Superstition. Look, I'll break this mirror. And then he bashes his head into the mirror and falls down bleeding.
That's 7 years bad luck.
Yeah, see, that's the whole idea.
7 years in the hospital.
Yeah, that's the whole thing. So the idea is there's some people out there who really believe in superstition. Dude! I believe in farts. You don't have to keep trying to prove it.
That's just Casper, the friendly fart. So there's his little brother, Junior. So my grandparents, especially my grandma on my dad's side, they were superstitious. And she broke a mirror one time and thought, for certain, she was going to have bad luck, like, because she thought there were evil spirits that came out of the mirror and were going to haunt her for the rest of her life. Wow. And it turned out that they wound up losing their middle son when he was about 3. And later on, her husband died. And then it's like she kind of felt like a lot of those bad things that were happening to her were because she broke that mirror. But then it's just, again, association. And they were far apart. Like, how long afterwards are you supposed to have
Is there a time limit? You
know? Right.
Well, that was one of the
things. So then you can be in the mindset of, like, oh, bad things are going to happen to me. Every time something bad happens, you associate it to
There was a comic strip that said, you know, you can go ahead and, you know, have, like, break a mirror, and then you can blame anything bad that happens afterwards on breaking the mirror. But maybe there'll be an amazing circumstance where nothing bad will happen to you. Nothing at all.
Or maybe something good.
But then you could do something but then you could do something bad to yourself and then blame it on the mirror.
Right.
Well, it's the same thing as blaming everything or on all good things on God, you know.
Yeah. You don't blame it on the rain.
The rain?
Gosh. Hey, Stevie Wonder, not Billy Billy.
Oh, you know, this reminds me of, like, you know, like the everything comes in threes.
Oh, that's a big one.
And it's like, that's like good. Celebrity deaths. It's always coming
out. I know.
You know, it's like, shit, there's like, how many celebrities out there?
But yes, there's a reason why. There's a reason why, because our brain is made to remember three is like what it's...
You know, Bob Hoskins died today, so that means two more.
Yeah. Is he the one or is he the third of another? Is he the second of Egon?
Oh, was it the 29th? Oh, I just saw it today.
But yeah, that's one of those things that this is a really good example of like junk science. This is how a lot of pseudoscience operates. Is if you start with your premise and then work backwards from there, you can make all the data fit your criteria. Sure. And then all of a sudden you have a false positive. Because, okay, look at it. They die in threes, okay? What's the time frame? And then what's the clumping? Like, okay, if they're more than 2 weeks apart, does that mean that they're part of the first group of three or the second group of three?
Yeah.
And then what defines a celebrity? You know, like, someone was a star on a big program, obvious celebrity, but then do you start counting, like, oh, someone was the weatherman on this particular news station, right? Do they count as a celebrity?
Yeah.
Then you start going to really minor things, like, oh, here's someone who was a bronze medal winner in the Olympics. They're a celebrity, too, right? Yeah. So then you start spreading your criteria to make things...
It's like with most things, you start... Yeah? Every time you start... delving further and further into it, it falls apart.
But what's really amazing is that people really believe these things because they don't think critically at all. They really think, wow, it's amazing. Things come in three. They don't think that maybe there's another reason. Or, oh, you know, I really can't open this umbrella in the house because there's going to be bad luck. And they really feel that way, even though, no, but think about it.
You know what's one of the ones that... extend.
All right.
One of the ones that a lot of people... I don't know if you guys realize it, but that idea about there are more... there's more action in the emergency room during a full moon.
Oh, right. Yeah.
That's not really true.
True.
And again, it speaks to confirmation bias because it's like someone's having a really hectic night in the ER room and they go out for a quick smoke break or whatever they're going to do, right? They might look up in the sky and they don't see a full moon. They're not going to remember that time. Mm.
Right, yeah.
But the time they see a full moon, they go, oh, no wonder it's so crazy.
Yeah. Right, yeah.
You know? And then the other times they'll know it's a full moon beforehand and they go, oh, I'm in for a doozy tonight. And then they're going to start, it might be an average night, but they're going to start making bigger deals of things. Like, oh my gosh, this is really
Friday the 13th going crazy. Is just like that. And that's part of it too, is with Friday the 13th where it's like, oh, I forgot yesterday was Friday the 13th. I wasn't paying attention. Did anything bad happen?
Right, you gotta retract all that.
Well, let's see. If it didn't, isn't that good?
Car accident on the freeway.
And stepping on cracks, that's always fun because you learn that when you're a kid.
Break your mama's back. Oh, yeah. No, it's Stevie Wonder.
But no, that's just
there's cracks everywhere!
But there's also an OCD.
Or is it a line?
Oh, I don't. Yeah, that, yeah, exactly.
It's a crack.
Why?
Is it a line where the sidewalk separates? Is that like a crack or is that a line? But no, it's still, even, it's an OCD thing. It's like, oh, I want to only step on the cracks or I only want to step on the.
Yeah.
But
it's kind of like saying, you know, like if you're off the couch, you're in the lava.
Yeah,
come,
I know.
You can link
yeah.
to that video.
Oh, yeah.
Before time, I don't know what time we're at, but I do want to get into four-leaf clovers, cool. because do you remember
Well,
the
that's
time,
fine,
because
luck is next.
Do you remember the time that we were looking for four-leaf clovers at Longden School?
Oh, yeah!
Like, that was like our destiny that summer or something. Was like,
you know what?
There's a huge patch of clovers.
You know
we're just
the
like
irony
looking
is,
through them. And,
you need the luck to begin with. to yeah. find so if you find the damn clover first, you're like, oh, look at all these clovers!
Yeah. And luck is our next topic, so good luck, bad luck. I want to start this off with... talking about Vegas, I was in Vegas once for Ed's editorial's wedding, I believe. Yeah. I'm not sure if that was it. But we were just hanging out at a craps
was that
table.
2003?
I don't remember what it was. Yeah. But we were hanging out at
if
a craps,
I got the year wrong,
craps table, and it must have been, he must have been there, because that's the only reason I would have been gone to a craps table. And we go there, and...
wait, he was doing a Cincinnati French.
In Vegas.
What's a Cincinnati Vegas bow tie cartwheel?
They say, all right, roll.
So there was this guy who was just, as they say, like he was really, what do you call it when you're doing, you're hot or you're, where you really.
He was having a hot
streak. Yeah, having a hot streak. And he was doing awesome.
He was on fire.
And his luck was just amazing. And he yeah. was, he, and then finally he stopped. He wouldn't lose. And he's like, I'm done. He threw like $500 to the guy next to him because he helped him with something, and he walked off. And the next guy gets the dice, rolls it.
Bust.
Total right bust. Craps yeah. out yeah. right away. And so it's one of those things where I thought, oh, there must be some sort of energy there. It's luck. There's the something term. To luck. Yeah. Like, there's some superstition to luck. But in reality, I mean, that's me seeing one event and thinking that's luck.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, isn't luck just it's a like, combination of good things that happen together?
It's like having a being in a raffle. I mean, you're staring at your raffle tickets, and they're doing the numbers off and stuff. And yeah. if you hit your number, you're like, yeah, you know? It was, like, destined for me.
Well, we want to see patterns and things again, and it's just like the lotto numbers. Like, state lotteries and everything, they'll list the most frequent numbers that come up. And are those numbers the most frequent because the ball happens to have some imperfection that gets chosen more often?
Or it's fixed.
Not likely, but more what happens is randomness is clumpy.
Yeah.
That's the thing, is like randomness winds up evening out in the long term. But when you take short samples of anything that's random, you're going to find clumpy data.
Yeah,
and if you definitely. Sift through that data with the right kind of criteria, you're going to find what you think is information in the noise. But yeah. just because, you know, like number 42 came up 5 times in the last week doesn't mean it's destined yeah. to come up any more often again. It's
probability,
still one out of
four. Well, probability is very very interesting statistical science. It's just the way it works.
You know, if you're, you know, flipping coins and betting money mm-hmm. on it, and it came up like tails 5 times in a row, you'd be very you'd clearly want to choose head or. Well, some people would choose
exactly,
tails,
yeah.
because it's on a streak.
Or
other
heads,
people would say, no, it's been tails so many times, it's got to change soon.
That has nothing
the best
to
thing
do with it.
Vegas
right.
did was put the on the roulette wheel.
The roulette, the last
showing the last, like, 10 numbers
that
come up. And
nothing
so you
to do
start
with
seeing
it.
Patterns like it's been red.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah,
blacks
yeah.
do. Blacks are due.
Yeah, which yeah. has nothing. And, you know, it's the whole thing is that what is luck? I mean, what do you really define luck as?
You see, that's someone profiteering on your superstitions.
Well, luck is getting something positive out of something.
Uh-huh.
And bad luck is just getting something negative.
And it's once again you putting them together into a group,
yeah.
into a pattern, saying, wow, I had a lucky day because all these good things happened to me. Because
I got laid.
There's no luck.
You're just
you're
just correlating with something. You know, you're
I think,
like cause and effect type thing they were talking about. Like, it's because of this,
yeah.
I got this positive.
Well, you're absolutely right. Only I think the one thing I would add to that is say that not only is luck something good or bad happening, but it's through no fault or I don't know, through your own doing.
Right. Yeah. Like, there's no control over it, even though
right.
you might think you might be able to control it.
Like, I wouldn't necessarily say I had a lucky day if I like went out there and just like kicked ass because I was doing good.
Right.
You know?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Or I sucked.
Right.
I sucked and stayed in bed all day. I'm not going to say damn my luck. You know, my bad luck.
It's actually we call
right.
it luck when we're not like actually doing something in control of
right.
it. Yeah. Very
right.
interesting.
I think it's
luck.
Just something that comes just natural to say too, because. I'll see, like, you play softball, and you get a ball right by you real quick, and you almost got hit.
Is it loud all of a sudden?
Yeah, another loud. Okay, next up, Urban Legends. Flashing the headlights because gang members are going to come kill you or whatever, melting contacts, and buried Atari cartridges. Oh, what was real?
Yeah. Did I put that in there because the story came out?
Yeah.
Cool. What's Melting Contacts?
Melting Contacts was one that I saw on Facebook that was saying it's actually based on an old thing, but the new one says if you stare, there's a person who stared at a barbecue. Yeah. And while they're staring at the barbecue, their contacts melted because they were too close to the barbecue. Oh,
awesome.
And so, of course, and they show pictures of people with eye damage, and you're like, oh my God.
Yeah.
And of course, I went to Snopes right away. Yeah. And it's actually based on this older legend of welding, that people would be wearing contacts, and while welding, they looked at the welding and it melted on them.
Oh, that would suck.
But it didn't happen. That also was not true. So it's one of those things where we're very lucky now that we can take a look at the
I would kind of think that your eyes would fail before the contacts.
Yeah, see, and that's just it. They're not going to melt.
Right.
And I just couldn't think of any, when I was writing this, I couldn't think of any other urban legends that weren't, I'm trying to stay away from viral myths because that's next.
Actually,
so I want to think about traditional urban legends. There was the headlight one where if you're driving down the street and you blink your headlight, if someone blinks, you blink their headlights because the person coming your way has the headlights off, that's a gang member. They're going to come around and follow you and kill you. Or they have the brights on,
Some neighborhoods it might be,
Well, no, I think that maybe there was once that happened, but I think for the most part it was not a real thing. I think
Snopes basically shot it down.
It was just a story.
One that I had to actually do actual research and prove it wrong to people was that cats suffocate babies because they smell the milk and suffocate them.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
And so when Logan was born, there were some people that were just all like, you need to get rid of your cat. You got to get
rid of
your
cat. Really?
They want us to get rid
of
our
cat.
And I'm like, you're nuts. You know? I mean, if this was true, there'd be all this research.
But
everything you look up is just, it's a wives' tale.
Yeah. No offense to old wives.
Yeah. But and the cat slept with Logan.
Could be an old man tale, too.
For those of you who don't know, there was an urban legend that said that in the 80s, Atari, during the video game slumper crash or whatever they called it, the video game crash in 82 or 83, they had all these ET cartridges, which is a game I actually kind of liked. It was crappy, but as a kid, I liked it.
We were young and dumb.
Yeah, we were.
I remember liking it too.
It's just like, oh, it's ET.
It was like, you can get out of the pit. Anyway, so the whole thing is that the urban legend was they buried it in somewhere in New Mexico, and they're doing a documentary about the video game crash of the 80s, and they actually went out with a film crew and they unearthed it.
What is interesting about that, though? Part of the reason why they buried all these cartridges is at the time they were with Time, was it Warner Brothers had bought Atari at the time? And they made this really stupid decision because the movie E.T. was so hot. They basically said, okay, we're going to print this huge run of cartridges. They actually printed more cartridges than there were game systems.
Oh, okay.
Wow. And they were thinking it was going to drive the sale of the systems so much that the systems would catch up.
What are some?
And that's part of why they had all these extra cartridges that they wanted to bury.
What are some other urban legends? Did you guys think of anything that's not, like viral myths from today? I can't
slap your back. You make faces and someone slaps your back.
Salt it'll stay shoulder.
That way. Hairy palms.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I stayed there. It was right off the strip. No, wait. That was the massage parlor.
Whack off too much.
Get the hairy palms.
Right.
Yeah.
Or you go blind.
Yeah, or you go blind. Yeah. That's
I would have been blind a long time ago.
So, yeah, I guess a lot of urban legends maybe were used for control. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Now it's become more, the viral thing on the internet has become more of internet graffiti, which brings us to the next one, which is viral myths.
Nicely timed.
The internet has proliferated viral myths.
Oh, no, that was skill.
Luck
skill.
Yeah. So things such as Snopes, Mythbusters, and Captain Disillusion, how they debunked them. So with the internet, that contact one was an example of it, even though it was based on an old one, where someone I knew had posted it. And I was like, I looked it up on Snopes, and I was like, this isn't real. Don't worry about it. So,
all that stuff that's posted isn't real.
There's a lot, and it's great that it's like the whole thing with the virus. Like, there's a virus for a computer, so then antiviruses come out. The antiviruses for viral stuff that are myths are things like Mythbusters or Captain Disillusion or Snopes. Like, the one that I like,
they're like the immune system for misinformation.
Right, yes, exactly. Yeah, and I like that Mythbusters did the whole cell phone in the gas station thing, where they had it, like, in a thing full of gas, and they put a spark, it was nothing.
By the way, I want to just mention for the sake of argument, that Snopes seems to do very thorough investigation, mm-hmm. and I agree with trust them a lot.
That's the first place I go.
And they reference all their sources. Yeah. Mythbusters, on the other hand...
Well, yeah, it's more for entertainment.
They are, right, they're entertaining, and they're awesome, don't get me wrong. But they're not exactly always scientifically rigorous.
Right.
Yeah. Mm. And I think that... That's one thing that maybe they should emphasize a little bit more than they do. Oh, to say, like, you know, we're doing this for fun. Even though we're going to call it busted or confirmed, we're one little experiment.
Right. We're that's a very good point.
Properly blinded, et cetera.
You know, I'm glad you said that because I always kind of take what the Mythbusters say as the truth, and you've got a very good point there.
I think it's like it's the first step. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's the first step to find out what's really
makes
there.
People
well,
think,
it's amazing
think
that
about
even
it.
That yeah. they're semi, you know, looking at it correctly. Gives you the answer most of the time anyway.
Yeah.
They don't even have to go rigorous to show that, oh, this is bullshit.
Sure.
So, what I was saying earlier...
But I think you have to take it all with a grain of salt, because some of them could be opposite.
Grain of salt? Why would you do that?
Because I'm superstitious about it, okay? I'm going to throw the salt over my shoulder.
I've actually done that before when I was growing up, throwing salt over my shoulder.
Because someone was eating your, you know...
There was actually a comic I saw when I was looking at it that had two snowmen, and one of the snowmen has this big gouge out of his shoulder, and says, I guess throwing salt over your shoulders isn't always good luck. but what I was saying is it's really...
And he buttered his carrot.
Knock on wood.
It really is electronic graffiti where, you know, people want to get these things out there where they're saying, you know, oh, I'm going to scare people and work on this frame of mind saying where they're going to think it's real, and then people do. And how about, I think, one of the biggest ones that I think the internet helped proliferate.
The burn baby?
No, a serious one. That autism is caused... By vaccines. And it's starting to show now as there are more outbreaks of things like measles.
Yeah.
And the science is finally getting through to people who are like, oh, no, I'm not vaccinated.
Even Jenny McCarthy now is saying, she's like, well, what I really meant was.
And that's the whole thing is there can be damage and danger in this if you don't have the antiviruses, the immune system, such as Snopes.
And she just blamed it because she had nothing else to blame. That her child had autism, so she just correlated with the vaccine.
Yeah, like, I mean, everyone wants to have a reason for things to happen, and you know, it sucks to think that it makes you feel better.
Yeah.
Right, it's God's a genetic will. Mutation. I mean, it's horrible to have anyone deal with, you know, having a child who's autistic because it's a struggle for everyone involved. But you don't want to just have a villain out of convenience. You know, let's try to find out what really causes it, what can really cure it. And then just the kind of slander campaigns they led against vaccines, like saying, oh, there's mercury in it, when it was actually like...
Whatever. All right, so conspiracy theories. They've gotten a lot of legs. How do you say it? Traction. A lot of traction with the internet, especially the 9/11 conspiracy theories. But I mean, the Kennedy assassination has always been a fun one. You know, even when I was young, I was like, "Ooh, who really killed Kennedy? I can't wait till they open the documents."
Home of JF Kennedy,
hey,
who tragically was shot.
Ooh, welcome to the appetite.
Why did that make us dance?
The JFK could really be a true... I mean, I think it's a true conspiracy. And is it in 2026? Somewhere around there?
I don't think it's a true conspiracy. I don't know. What do you think happened, Paul? You think that
if it's a true conspiracy...
Well, no, I don't know.
It's very small.
Yeah, but it's just interesting that everything was sealed right after that. But we're going to be around, hopefully.
There was probably something that went wrong in somewhere in there that would have hurt people, but I don't think it's like...
But this is like Project Blue Book when it was coming out. Yeah. Like, we're actually going to be around to see these documents unsealed and really get...
That was declassified maybe know the truth. Some time ago.
Yeah, and we were alive. Yeah.
But that's what he said.
We're going to be there.
For the Kennedy stuff.
Okay. Yeah.
You know what?
But I think it's going to be kind of like the same thing where there's nothing there. It's just eyewitness reports.
Whose vault was that Geraldo opened?
Al Capone.
Al Capone. It would be just like Al Capone. Just as I thought!
Yeah!
Dude,
he got Al Capone.
But
Al Capone.
You know what? I have this theory that in the future, somehow they're going to come up with some computer program that's going to be able to take any of the old photocopied documents that have things blacked out and be able to find the minute like differences in the color and he'll
show us
read
what it says.
What's
yeah,
underneath
no
it?
Kidding. No kidding.
It'll just say blackout, 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 blackout.
Or some like they used to be able to do with some things. You shine it with infrared light. Now you can see it.
Shows
it'll be
lights.
Some wavelength like ultraviolet. You know, farther down the line.
So what else was there? There was, of course, the Blue Book, the aliens. You know, people still think that we've got alien technology and the Men in Black and stuff. There's the hidden government and all that. I don't know. What 9/11 has been crazy, though. I mean, it's just so obvious that it's not... oh, my God. Can you imagine how much planning would have had to go in to something like that and there's just no evidence?
Can we clarify how this deals with superstition specifically? Because we dealt with this for Supernatural, a lot of this kind of stuff.
We did touch on this, and actually we're dealing with it now, too, because it's the same. I'm trying to focus superstition in the frame of mind of how people will believe things just based on things they see on their own experience.
So you're establishing the pattern of people buying into things. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so in a way, it's connected to superstition, or it's connected to Supernatural, but this is I'm kind of looking at more for the 9/11 thing.
Yeah,
because that's real, and
well,
the
we were
Kennedy
talking
assassination.
About, like, data mining before, where you if you don't start with like the premises, like celebrities dying in threes, right? If you go in with a preset of like how far apart they need to be, all that stuff before you see the data. Then you can try to find matches, and you basically won't. It's just noise, right? And that's data mining. Now, the other thing is anomaly hunting, and that's what happens with most of these conspiracy theories. It's like, ooh, did you see that one shot that they only showed on the news live one time, and there happened to be some weird thing in the corner? Or like when a certain shot of a plane going into the World Trade Center, people point out that it looks like there's some little thing under the wing and they claim it's a drone
missile
or something.
Yeah.
But it's all this stuff where there's so much data out there, they just look for little things to nitpick on.
The reason I put down sports superstition was because I really think this focuses on the frame of mind. Why do people honestly believe something small they do will affect a larger event to which it's completely unconnected? Now, we talked about wearing the lucky socks to go out and play could give you, you know, a boost. But I'm talking about wearing the lucky socks, and because you wore the lucky socks, your team, who's playing 1,000 miles away, won. Or because you did. And the thing is...
well, that's because God likes your lucky socks.
Well, yeah.
And it's on their side.
That's true. Well, sports is very...
but if you're not wearing the lucky socks, God's like, screw you, Buster.
People will get serious about this. Yeah. Like, if you're the guy sitting in the group and you do something you're not supposed to,
right?
Like, your friends will be pissed off at you. That they'll say,
well,
it's
you
your
need
fault.
New friends then.
Damn it!
No, I remember watching. There's well, I move. I watch us. Football and stuff, okay. And I actually move seats
well,
because if the team starts doing bad, I know it's me. So I sit over there and they start doing good.
You stay there.
I stay there.
I got a warning over here.
I got 40. Oh, 40 minutes! 40 minutes, 30
nice.
Seconds!
Okay.
Should I pause and keep going?
I don't know. Your battery saying is low, even though you're plugged in. It's what? Still
oh, that's all right.
Oh, well.
I'm sure it's fine. Did you actually plug in the thing, or is it...
yeah.
All right.
It's probably... this, the charger's probably not full
well, you,
rate.
You just jerked it. I don't know if it...
oh, no!
That's fine.
All right.
There we go. We got a little camera action there. Okay, back to the podcast.
Okay.
All right, so sports is very routine, and I see this too, like...
that's a good point. Lots of waiting around.
A lot of waiting around.
Yeah,
nice
yeah.
That's but
one,
even when
yeah.
I'm playing, oh, go ahead. When I'm playing softball and I'm pitching, and I start getting off or I'm not hitting the plate, I'm not getting strikes or whatever, I start humming the He-Man theme.
Nice.
I did that once.
Nice.
And I started hitting the plate again.
Yeah.
So I mean, I know it's not I'm not superstitious,
right?
But it's just like even last week I walked somebody and out of nowhere. I'm like, I better just do it. So I just did it anyways, and I hit the plate.
Yeah, see, and
it just gets you in the frame of mind, and it's...
and see, and that's a case where it'll work, but I'm talking more along the lines of affecting something that you have no connection to at all.
I have also blown...
whoa!
a shot of air. I have...
you just
out the window
fall down in the other
before
room.
A field goal, and they missed. It was my whims, the butterfly
you're like,
effect.
You're like,
all the way across the country...
so the last time you were at bat, you were doing the He-Man theme, and then you pointed over toward first base, and you turned the runner into battle cat. So, Like, sorry, my bad.
Sorry.
Oops. Yeah. No, well, they didn't turn into Battle Cat. They just got the big thing on them. They're like, yeah. What the hell?
Why do I look like a retarded vulture?
But yeah, it's the sports thing, and it's just the frame of mind is that people will really believe it.
Well, when I, even though I have no belief in superstition whatsoever, every time that I've watched a sports team, they've lost. When I'm watching whatever team,
whenever you watch, one of them will lose.
Oh my god, that's so.
And one of them always wins.
I meant the ones that I was rooting for.
No, seriously, it does seem like every time I don't go to Dodger games very often, but every time I go,
they lose.
Oh, it's always
lose. And then again, it's like that's another confirmation bias because I obviously think that, then I remember the times it's true,
and there's nothing.
I forget the times they won.
And there's nothing wrong with that as long as you're not basing something important off of it,
right?
Like a friendship. And luckily we're not like that, but I've talked to people who have to deal with that.
You don't like my Dodgers? You don't like my Dodgers?
No,
I hate you.
Holy shit.
It's very, very superstitious.
People do take it seriously and take sports very seriously.
Teams, they'll slap the sign walking out. There's
the beards. Was it the Kings?
Oh, you do the rally beards. There's always rally beards during the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Superstitious beliefs. Like, people will put the rally beards on. Superstitious beliefs is the next one.
Yeah, it's the next one.
Oh.
Pull the... You're throwing us off. You got to pull the...
Religion, the secret.
Oh, did it ding?
Silence.
I wonder why you were talking.
Oh. That's why we're the one who's keeping us on track. Cutting you off, Do you want to extend?
No,
sports is kind of like your it's more involved than the rest of us.
So, but no, but what to go off of what he was saying for superstitious beliefs is if one of them had shaved their beard, it probably would have messed things up because they.
Oh yeah, it throws the whole team off.
It screws up the psychology.
I was like, it's all camaraderie.
Well, you know,
people believe it,
and the psychology,
right? Because the thing is, you're not individuals when you do a group thing like that. So they were acting as a team, and all of a sudden you're not part of the team if you defy them.
So
there's actually a real effect there, regardless of the superstition.
And what I wanted to bring up here was religion, of course, which we talked a little bit about last time with superstition. But also, I thought about The Secret, which was a book that Kale and I had read, and we felt there was some felt there was some kind of science behind it.
Oh no! Did you almost fall for it?
Yeah. Well, no, we're looking at it as...
Don't tell anybody where I touched you.
We are a little secret. No, we were looking at it as it was like subconscious, like you got yourself to.
I
to
prefer ladies speed stick.
We were investigating if it was a phenomenon of self-fulfilling prophecy.
Yeah, and there was that scary guy. What was his name? Bob
Proctor.
Oh, that guy was scary. Anyway,
every time he talked, it was like so angry and it'd make Joey jump.
Yeah, he's scary. Anyway, but The Secret is another one of those things where it's self-fulfilling because it would be like you'd send it out to the universe.
Right, and then it gives back.
And then it comes back to you. And goes, hey, look,
Well, what was really interesting...
I have a feeling the universe doesn't care what you think.
It's a cold
if it even has a conscious mind. Right. I remember my sister was big into The Secret, really believing it, and saying, you know, how the positive things, you know, you make things happen. And I thought, I told her, I said, well, what about all the serial killers out there who are focusing and thinking on those people that they want to kill?
Oprah's like the anti-Snopes.
And so they keep thinking about them, and it becomes a bigger and bigger thing. What about all those people?
What'd you say?
And she went, and she hadn't really thought about that before. It's like your positive would be going up against
and
all
so
these
negative,
negatives.
Yeah,
if it was
a lot
true.
Of negative thought out there. And the
balance of power.
Well, you know who else? There's someone else's sister who believes in it.
Yeah.
Unless you want to. Okay, let's not go there.
Probably not.
Okay.
And there's also superstitious silence, which is another one I wanted to bring up.
Yeah, I didn't know what...
Because I kind of put my name on it.
Silence.
I mean, I made the name up, kind of. It's where you don't talk about something because you're afraid it will happen.
Oh,
and that's very...
That's in sports.
Yeah, that's part
of
it.
You don't talk about a no-hitter.
Right, yeah.
Because you're going to jinx it.
But the big one is death. Like, there's important things that you have to think about if death is going to happen, and you don't want to talk about it because it's... I mean, this is how I feel sometimes. If I talk about it, what if it's like, it's going to happen. But and then if it happens, I'll be like, oh, I should have talked about it. But you've got to talk about these
how
things.
How would you
I
know?
Guess we didn't get much into the cultural
aspects. No, if he dies, how would he know?
No. I'll let them talk first.
I don't know.
Because I think, like, overall, just this is kind of stereotype, whatever, but... I think you can make a case that there are strong superstitions in many Asian cultures. And just talking about, like, not mentioning something like death, even in gesture, it's like a taboo to pass food from chopstick to chopstick at a Japanese restaurant or a Chinese restaurant.
Don't cross the chopsticks.
I hope I'm not mixing them up. I think it's true in both cultures, but damn it!
Extend it for Daryl.
In funerals,
extend for you.
At cremations, they would pass the bones using chopsticks from one person to another. So you're signifying death by passing food from one person to another.
Oh, interesting.
That. So it's just a symbolism of death, but they don't even want it, like, that's not dinner time conversation. And if you do it during dinner time, you might be causing someone to die, you know?
Yeah. And of course, then we come to the whole idea of religious beliefs. And for anyone who doesn't believe in the religion, that religion is a superstition. And there's a very popular, not really a meme, but a picture on the internet where it says, it has the very little kid going like, oh, Easter Bunny, please... please bring this, or what was it?
It was the progression.
Yeah, and then the older one's like, please Santa Claus, and then the other one's, please God.
Yeah. By the way, we didn't get in, because I got this fetish about defining things. You know?
Fetish?
Did we go into, because it comes up every time. What's a cyborg?
Yeah. Speaking of defining, I don't think that's the right definition of fetish.
I don't think that means what you think it means.
Fetish is like...
All right. We're going to get into that. Go.
You guys my feet?
Where was your original idea?
Okay, because like supernatural is obvious, but like what's a stition? Right?
Yeah, I don't know.
So, what makes a stition
super? I don't know.
Or beyond stitionness.
We'll try for the show notes to find the origin of the word super.
Okay. Superstition.
Is titus.
Oh, I like those.
What time does Sean Connery show up at Wimbledon?
I don't know, but it looks like tennis.
Yeah. So, but religion is also superstition for people who don't believe in it. So that's very, and that's a lot of self-fulfilling prophecy and everything that we've talked about before as well.
So. I saw your mother at Wimbledon.
Anyway. By what time did you see her?
I was about 11, you bastard. Some bitch shows up late every time.
All right. So I want to bring this all into the superstitious frame of mind. So we've already talked a lot about this, the idea of pattern recognition. But the fact is that we all do it. And I think as long as it's not causing any big problems, it's fine.
Well, it becomes communities get drawn together through superstition. So
that's a good point.
If you're part of a community, it's kind of what you all do together.
Yeah, that's
so
much like the rally beards.
Yeah,
yeah.
And like I said,
or the playoff
you get beard. Drawn into the fun things, and then you get pulled into because of that into some more scary things that are superstitious.
Yeah, I think everybody's got to be critically thinking though, and realize that superstitions
Have to be. But I mean, it's nice that they are.
Yeah, Daryl, go ahead.
Well, you're saying like you have to be a critical thinker. Well, no, I think some people get through life without doing a whole lot of that.
I meant when I said that, I meant it would be best.
Okay.
Well, so that's too much thinking.
Well, now we're telling everyone what's best.
I am, yeah.
Kyle, Joey. Anyway.
Hey, I'm not the one with the barber named Adolf.
Yeah, right? No kidding.
Yeah, well,
yeah, who would go to a barber named Adolf? I mean, really.
So,
he's what?
Yeah, he's not German. He's Mexican. Yeah.
Show me your paper! Hey.
No, I asked him where his papers are.
You want to see me?
That was kind of bad. All right.
Oh, Daryl. What frame of mind are you in?
I'm sorry. That's a green card, not papers.
It doesn't matter. It was offensive either way.
It's easy to get into superstitious beliefs and stuff because it kind of just solves mysteries, answers.
It gives answers. It's the same as before we were talking about. That's important.
Yeah,
that's all.
If you want answers, and that really is true. We all are seeking for answers. So if we can find them through superstition, we've got an answer, and at least that's better than nothing
for a
lot of people.
And like. Oh gosh, you go.
I was gonna say, and people want to their brains are making stories, they're making models of the world, and what we're doing most of the time is taking all these pieces of information all around us, which is really very discombobulated. It's all over the place, and the brain is putting it together in one smooth story for us to understand. And so it does that with superstitions as well, even if they're not supposed to be tied together.
I think it's also used kind of like how you use metaphors and stuff. It's like I'll be talking to somebody and I'll say something like, oh, you know, if something dies, I'm like, ooh, knock on wood. I don't really believe it, but it just kind of just...
And that's a good point.
It's natural in the conversation. It's just part of your language.
Well, I think that's part of memory, too, because like, how do you remember something random, right? Because we have a lot of random information around us. We remember patterns and remember associations as well. So the thing is, we always want to take something we want to remember and associate it with something else, and also form a pattern out of it. Mm-hmm. And that means that we have to kind of cull the data so that we can fit it into a pattern or adjust it as necessary. So we make all the universe make sense to us. And that's like forming a mnemonic to remember something. Like if you have a password for something, you can make it the first letters of like a song lyric or something. And that way you have a pattern and something you can remember, like the ABCs. You can remember the alphabet because it all goes in order. It's a pattern you recognize.
And the song.
But it's hard to learn at first, right? So the thing is, if you had all this unpatterned information that you had to learn and repeat to yourself over and over again until you finally had it down, like the alphabet, we would never remember much of anything. So we it's actually like a function of our minds where we have to...
Oh my God!
Yeah.
All right, so... What's our superstitious conclusion? Have you ever been superstitious? I'll talk about mine. Was when I'm gambling, I'll be like, oh, if I do this, then I'm gonna win more. Yes. Ah, it worked. It has nothing to do with it. And I'm talking about like things that might work, like if I'm touching the touch screen a certain way.
Yeah.
You know, I'm thinking the program in the computer has got a secret back
that's
door.
Your fetish.
Yeah. Well, it's trying to control a situation that you have no control
Sicko.
Over.
So it's supposed to be a random... let's see if this one is, too. It's still giving me the battery warning.
So when have you guys used Superstition?
I remember using Superstition during the Bucks-Rams game in 2000. I was in Vegas, and I had $100 on the game, and I wanted the Bucks to win, and I sat there, and I had my leg with my left leg crossed up on my right... And they weren't doing too well. When I moved my right over my left, and they scored a touchdown. I didn't move, and they won the game.
What about you, Kale?
That's the last time you watched from the toilet.
You said you...
that's when I broke my phone.
You said you threw salt over your shoulder once, but can you remember anything?
Yeah, definitely. I remember when I went bowling with my family once, and I started just... In my head, I started humming the theme to Popcorn. You know, dun 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 dun. It's an old song. Anyway, it's an instrument.
Sounds like Do the Hustle.
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, I can't even remember it now, but I remember doing it, and I scored a... I knocked down all the pins.
Sorry.
So I did it again, and... This is becoming my superstition. Yeah. Every time I start to talk, everybody else talks.
That is not a superstition.
That's a reality, isn't it?
We don't tech talk. God. We just talk.
Daryl, you come last.
And then it just falls apart.
Then it just falls apart.
Oh, wait, it's my turn. I was trying not to talk over the complaining guy.
Oh, were you still going?
So you got a strike. Okay. So I kept humming
every time I went up there, and some guy next door complained, and my mom yelled at him, said, oh, just let him do it. And I kept getting strikes.
Every time so I bowl I now, it. I'm going to hum The Hustle.
Yeah. It's not even the right song, but you'll get a strike.
Okay. Yes!
So,
guaranteed.
So I think I was more superstitious back when I was Christian, because I had this, you know, God belief and belief in spiritualism.
Jesus is going to spank you.
And I kind of thought, you know, if I get God on my side, then God will do wonderful things for me. So you can think of religious belief as being like a big lever or an amplifier, you know, because it's like you have a little tiny bit of influence in the world, but you're friends with this God that has humongous influence.
Right.
So you're going to try to be the thing that tells that God what to do. Like, hey, be on my side, yo.
Hey, biatch, do some stuff.
So I think I did a lot of superstitious things based on my religious belief. Like, I kind of thought it was similar to The Secret, where, like, a positive attitude would get God on my side, and then I would have an ally, and I wasn't alone, and I would be able to do more
things more powerfully.
But I've given all that up, just kind of realizing that that was more the power of my own, you know, a change in my sensibilities just by thinking more positively. I think I get something out of that. It doesn't make me think more negative because I no longer believe in the superstition aspect of it. It's just, I think it's healthy.
Positive does make
it's good for your health to be positive about things. Even if the chips are down, you should still kind of go, well, let's make lemonade out of this, you know, these lemons I've been served. And
somebody chop my
balls sir.
Off.
Make cool. lemons out of lemonade. Yeah. Wait, that would mean you have a time machine. Okay. That was
that makes sense.
Or you're really good at reversing entropy.
Now it's Sophie's choice. I mean, Daryl's choice.
That was the final episode of my super series.
Super trilogy.
Next week, next time will not be super fudge. It will be something completely different.
It'll be a super pack.
No, I checked the dictionary. There's really
super
nothing else.
Pack.
Oh, okay.
I was like, super. super fudge pack. I still like Daryl's super salad. That's pretty good.
Super salad.
Yeah. That was
Daryl, you are up.
I want to say about super salad. I remember the time we were out with Joe, and somebody asked him at the restaurant, super salad. He said, yes.
How do you sink a boat?
Because he thought it was a super salad.
My mom.
I was like, really? I loved it. I was like,
my mom did that too when she came here from Australia. She has the same story. Super salad, yes.
I remember doing that with me. Maybe he said yes because of your mom's story.
Maybe that was it. I don't know. Well, once I had a...
it was so funny.
I worked with a girl.
4 minutes before I even say what my episode is.
No, there's no...
I should stop it then.
Yeah. There was
sorry, show's over.
When I worked at Virtual World, or I guess it was Flatter Town at the time, we went out to eat once, and one of the girls was a younger girl, she was like 18, and she said, I'll take the eggs any style.
Nice.
And the waiter's like, yeah. I'll do the any style.
She called you up for tech support. She was like, where's the any key?
Yeah. All right, so Daryl, have you chosen for next week?
I have not.
We know you have.
Okay, so
as long as it's not complicated.
Mine has something to do with reputation.
Mine is word to the wise, and that's WHYS.
Word to my homie.
So I want to ask all the why questions, like, why is the sky blue? Ooh. Why do we laugh?
Magic.
Why do people
Magic.
Play?
Magic.
Why do people sleep?
It's not the reputation of economy... complicated.
No, not reputation based.
Why do we pick in
this? Oh, that's kind of awesome.
I did that to throw you off the trail.
Oh, you threw my ass off.
Sniffing the wrong tree.
No, don't say sniff because he'll fart. Okay. No, that's awesome. I like it.
Paul.
The why, word to the
wise.
Wait.
Why do I have to do that? You said it.
Well, part of what I want to make the show is I'm going to outline some of the things, but then I want to give us all opportunities. Like, you guys ask some why questions you've always wondered. You know, like, why is this thing blah, blah, blah? You know? Why does the Chromecast go blank when you aren't...
Why do we get touched by a stranger?
It'll be our little secret.
It's because it was canceled. That
you know, I tried tapping my foot in the stall and it didn't work.
Wait, what?
You ever heard that? Tap your stall next to somebody, it means you want gay sex.
No, I haven't heard that one. And I know to run next time someone does that. Okay.
Oh, crap. I do that all the time. Like, just when I'm sitting here.
It's a nervous habit.
Yeah, why is that guy so talky next to you?
Check the show notes.
That's why. All right, so that's going to be next week. I like it, Daryl. I think that's a really good choice. It's going to be very interesting.
I want to add one quick thing before we wrap up. That Richard Feynman has a famous quote, and I might have actually said it in a previous episode, so I'm not going to read the whole thing. But he essentially says that he's not afraid of not knowing. He actually thinks it's a very interesting thing. Like, we were talking about superstitions being, you know, we have to come up with explanations for things because we don't know and we want to have an answer for stuff.
Right.
And he's saying, you know what, as an atheist or a skeptic, it's fine not knowing. In fact, not knowing is what drives us to figure things out.
Ooh,
so he's thrilled to not know things.
Whoa. It's fine, man.
Yeah, it's totally fine. It's funky
fine. It's
dick
fine,
dick
man.
Dick fine.
You broke the law.
That's my leg for the next stall.
You broke the law, Tom. You had a dick fine.
No, that was breaking the speed limit.
Yeah. All right. So remember, you can always please email us, show@iamrambling.com, or make comments. We want to know you're out there. We know you are. Damn it. And yeah, so...
We're looking at you.
The swamp ass is...
Dude, I know, the swamp ass.
It is beyond just the ass right now.
We've got these bright lights on us.
We've got more heat than usual.
Yeah, and it was a hot, like, 90-degree day. And
Paul's been venting the whole time.
So
longest wrap-up ever.
Yeah, thanks.
Thanks so much.
This is Joey Shammel.
And Paul Hunter.
Kale Anderson.
Daryl George.
George.com. And remember, you can always find...
G-I-O-R-S.com.
You can always find...
Thanks for the plug.
I am rambling.com. So go there and say hi.
Just ramble when you get there.
Yeah. You guys need to wrap up soon.
Remember! Goodbye, goddammit! We're incoherent!
So you don't have to!
Thanks for listening. You can now stop screaming at the open air. Listeners should put their minds back in their upright positions and resume traditional thinking. Find us on iamrambling.com for access to all of our weekly ramblings, show notes, general discussions, and any projects from Incoherent Ramblings. Like us on Facebook and rate us on iTunes. So long, and thanks for all the fish.
Paul almost threw up. Oh my god.
Tasted it.
Oh, that's the last time you bite me a Riano burrito, isn't it?
Oh man, we gotta do that every week.
Oh my god. Okay, stop the video.